Want to know more about different careers? Career Track is traveling across beautiful British Columbia to show a day in the life of various professions. Heavy equipment operators, social workers, VR designers, and mechanics. After all, it's one thing to read about a job, but it's another to see it in action. So join us as we explore some of BC's in-demand jobs. You might be surprised by what you find.
Aquatic ecosystems are as delicate as they are complex. Our next guest works on the front line of environmental research, helping us better understand aquatic species and their habitats. Let's meet an aquatic ecosystems biologist. Aaron, this place looks awesome.
Thanks, it's great to meet you, Miriam. I have a bunch of fun stuff planned for us. Come on in.
My name's Aaron. I'm an aquatic ecosystems biologist, and I work for the Ministry of Waterlands and Resource Stewardship in British Columbia. Because I'm an aquatic biologist, a lot of what I do has to do with water or aquatic environments. I do a mix of field work, which means just going outside and actually doing things in the environment and nature with water, with fish, with bugs, and also data analysis. So I might arrive at the office at 7, and then we'll load whatever gear we need to go out into the field in trucks. Typically I'll drive between 1 and 3 hours to a location where there's something going on. So this might be looking at riparian habitat, we might be trying to collect fish or aquatic invertebrates, which is something I'm personally passionate about. I have in here an invertebrate sampler called a Cerber sampler. And basically we're gonna put that down into the rocks in the river. And then we're gonna disrupt all the rocks and try to collect as many bugs as we can in a net and have a look at them.
Fun, all right.
So I'm gonna start picking up rocks like this one, and then I'm gonna hold them in the water and then give them a really good scrub.
Okay, looks like you're doing the dishes.
I did an undergraduate degree at the University of British Columbia in the Faculty of Forestry. And later I did a master's degree through the Natural Resources and Environmental Studies Institute at the University of Northern British Columbia. In order to work outside, you need to get wet, you need to get rained on, you need to endure different temperatures, you need to get bit by bugs. For certain people, that's a big challenge. For other people, that just comes naturally. And so those are the types of people that tend to be drawn towards biology and other environmental careers. Everybody wants to go out into the woods and collect fish or count birds or measure trees. It tends to be a lot more challenging and less of interest to people to go back and stare at that data in a spreadsheet and write a report on it. In order to succeed in a field like this, it's probably 1/3 field work and then 1/3 data analysis and statistics and 1/3 information dissemination and writing. Okay, you're gonna be the sprayer.
Oh.
So if you squeeze this bottle, it's gonna spray. And so what I'm gonna do is take this net, turn it inside out, and I want you to try and spray what's ever in the net
out
onto the tray.
Got it, okay. Like this?
Yep. Okay, see any movement?
That's really cool, look.
They're called chorominids. They look like worms, but they're actually insects. Chorominids basically mean that this is an environment that's anoxic. It has very low oxygen levels.
Oh, this is fun.
No matter where you are, if you're in an urban center, if you're out in the boonies, there's always going to be an environment. Just go get involved, talk to people, try to have a positive impact on the environment. The more you do and the more you're involved, the better that'll set you up to have a career and develop that passion.
Aaron, I had such a great time today. It was so nice being outside.
Thanks, I'm glad you enjoyed it. It's always fun showing what I do.
Once again, I'm Miriam for Career Trek, reminding you that this career could be yours.